What is going on, y'all? So it's currently Saturday. It's about 5:15 to be exact. So I'm gonna be going on a little adventure, and I thought I'd bring you guys with me so you can see something else than, you know, me just lifting the weights and, you know, keeping it boring and all that. You know, I want to bring some adventure to the channel. But yeah, I'm gonna be going to the Topanga Canyon Lookout. You know, gonna try to catch a sunset, get some cool pictures, you know, show you what the view's like, and yeah, I'll just bring you guys on the adventure. Hope you guys enjoy it. Catch you guys in the next one.
One of them ones.
Western Road flows, I did this shit for my nigga Rennie. Back when we couldn't buy pizza cause we were down to pennies. Feel like
Alright, so we just pulled over, found this cool little spot over here. Got the whip back there. But yeah. There's this cool little rock that I was taking pictures on. Hopefully I don't fall down and eat shit, you know. But yeah, enjoy the view. This is why I don't do cardio or hike. I literally start to sweat. So this place is like 15 minutes off of the side of the road, and your boy's already winded. We're almost there. My friend said it takes like 15 minutes to get there, but this is the longest 15 minutes of my life. But it's worth it to get some pictures and enjoy a sunset, you know? But yeah, I'll show you once we get to the spot. All right, so we're just a few steps away from where I was gonna take you guys. As you can see, there's some people up there. But yeah, man, we got some cool scenery down here. It's kind of hard to see because of the lighting. But yeah, that's a big drop. Imagine me rolling down here. But yeah, I don't think you guys can see it because of the smog, but LA's right over that mountain. There's like the skyscrapers and stuff over there. You can see parts of the city over there. But yeah, we're almost here. About to catch sunset. Y'all, so we made it up to the top. Nice little scenery. Sun's about to go down, but yeah, I got some nice pictures up here. It's all tagged up, you know, ran into a couple of other peoples, you know, and trying to get in their shoots. But yeah, took us a good little 20 minutes to get up here. It was a little mob, not gonna lie. A little hole, wonder what happens if I fall in. But yeah, this is pretty cool. Yo, so today we got some squats. We're about to kill it. This man says he's feeling it. He probably, what, you got a 407? Not 407. 405 squat at RP of 7 or what?
Probably like 510.
Oh, shit.
Somewhere around there.
But yeah, me, I got a top double, so who knows? I can be anywhere from 520 to 530 pounds for a double. But yeah, currently warming up right now, and then, you know, I'll show you right when I hop in for that double. Stay tuned.
It's motherfucking game time!
Six pounds of chronic on my grandma's coffee table. That's how you remember it. That's how I remember it. Yeah, dipping to the liquor store. Nine in my khakis, script trying to get at me. My red Impala bumping like acne. My city attract me. Been shot, robbed, stabbed, chased.
Shorty love the way that I flow style. See the that concludes today's That concludes today's workout. After squats, we did step ups. We did a set of 20. A set of 20, a set of 30, and a set of 40, which was brutal, hella volume. And then we did three sets of 10 on RDLs, you know, to blow up those hammies. And then we did calf raises with the barbell and a plate. So basically with 135 pounds on our back off of a 45 pound plate. So good little bodybuilding session after, you know, the strength training part. And other than that, I hit a PR today. I hit 460, 470, which I've never done before. And then I had a top double at 530, which was, you know, new for me. But other than that, pretty successful training day. Tomorrow we got bench and let's see how that moves.
I am the master of my flesh. I command you, and you must obey.
Yo, my shoes have finally arrived. I ordered the triple black Air Fury Gods and I finally got the package. So I'm not gonna unbox it yet, but I will unbox it at my girl's house. So stay tuned for the next clip. But yeah, I've been waiting to get these. These are pretty like gangster in my opinion, but if I don't like how they look once I unbox them, probably gonna resell them. If not, I'm gonna keep them and wear them. Yo, so I'm coming at you from a different setting than usual. I'm in my girlfriend's baby brother's room. As you can tell, there's all this like kid stuff. And I'm also trying to keep my voice down so I don't make too much noise. But yeah, these are my triple black Air Fury Gods. I'm gonna do a little unboxing to show you guys what they look like. If you don't wanna see this and you just wanna see the lifting content, you can just skip over. But if you wanna see what they look like, then hey, I'm gonna open them. All right, so we got some scissors. Gonna open it right here. Some Nike Just Do It tape. Alright, we got the box open. Ooh. Big old box. Big old orange box. Alright, cool. So we got a little. And this one, nice. We got a bag. It's like, it looks like a tote bag or a book bag, whatever it is. Pretty big. Probably carry the shoes in here or something. I don't know. But let's skip to the main part. I heard there's shoelaces. I don't know what this is. We can find out later. All right, in here. Wrapping. We got the shoes. Each shoe comes individually wrapped in some like tinfoil looking thing. So yeah, let's get them out of the tinfoil. See what they look like. And then here's the shoe. So response, first time seeing them. Pretty cool. I mess with them. I'm not a sneaker channel guy, so I don't know how to give a review, you know what I'm saying? So I'm not gonna go into full detail about them. I'm just gonna say that, you know, I like them. They look cool in my opinion. They smell good. But yeah, like nice material. I think these are waterproof. That's all I can say, you know. I'm not gonna do a full on review because that's not what this channel is about. I just wanted to show you guys, you know, a quick little unboxing. But yeah, man, I fucks with them. But yeah, catch you guys in the next clip. It's probably gonna be tomorrow when I'm deadlifting. Because today I really got nothing to do. I'm just gonna work on some stuff and then eat. But yeah, I just wanted to include this in the video to show you guys, you know, something different. But yeah, catch you guys later. Three, two, one.
All right, so just hit, you know, a quick triple. First rep moved a little ugly, as you saw in the previous video, but the last two moved like butter. I don't know what happened. Probably was just a misgroove. But yeah, so today I had a top triple. Then we're gonna have five sets of four after on back offs, and then, you know, we'll see what goes on with the rest of the day. But other than that, I feel pretty good. The only issue I'm having is my pec feels a little tight, so that's probably what caused the little misgroove. But other than that, can't complain. I haven't moved 365 that quick in like forever, so pretty good day in my opinion. But yeah, catch you guys in the next clip. All right, so we got 340 on the bar. I'm gonna open up my first set of four with that weight. If it moves well, we'll go up, but if I end up shitting the bed, we'll stay at this weight. But yeah, right now just chalking up the hands, and then, you know, just gonna hop into it and see how it moves. Trying to get some solid presses after that heavy six I had in the middle of the week, which was a PR. It was 350 for six, right? So yeah, sure. Let's see if that doesn't affect me today with the volume I got. Yeah, so we're gonna stay at 340, not really feeling it. I think I'm taking a toll from Thursday's bench, because that's when I was moving 350 for my set of six, and I'm just not feeling it. So I feel like shit. Not like shit, but, you know, I'm just not at full capacity. I probably feel 80% of like what my strength is capable of reaching. But 340 for a set of four is not bad, especially after a top triple. I've never been able to move 365 that smooth. Usually, the way my first rep looked is how my third rep looks. And for me to move the last two reps like it was air, means I've been making progress ever since I competed and hit my 425 bench. But yeah, so I'm not gonna film these last three sets because it's gonna be the same weight. I doubt I'm gonna go down, but other than that, then yeah, we got Dallas after that, and we'll show you what that's gonna look like. That's another fun part of
pain in the ass.
Saturday suck, man. We got two compounds on Saturday while every other day it's just one compound, so Saturdays are brutal. Who knows if we'll do accessories today, because it kind of
might be dead.
I feel like crap, you know, but oh well, let's get strong.
Last finger on that one. So that concludes this week's video. It was nice, simple, and short. You know, went on a little adventure with you guys, showed a couple of days of how my lifting was going. And other than that, you know, let's look forward to a new week and see what content we can bring for you guys to enjoy. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Like, comment what you want to see, and subscribe.